Hello everybody, welcome to the world of programming. My name is Gina Aljala and I'm assistant professor in Alger Institute of Engineering and Technology. In previous video, we have already discussed the importance of C programming and why we have to learn programming in different various engineering fields. And today, we will discuss introduction and course content of our subject in detail. So start with introduction. You already know our subject name, that is programming for problem solving, and the course code of our subject is 311-0003 in Gujarat Technological University, and the subject credit is 4, and the teaching scheme is like in weekly basis we have to learn 3 lectures and 2 hours lab session, and in one semester you have to give one university exam of 70 marks and 2 mid-sem exam or internal exam, and our subject is offered in first or second semester in different various engineering field. The main motive of today's video lecture is to explain course content in detail. So just see the building block of C. It indicates our C programming language, and we have to learn total 10 different modules to complete the journey of C programming. So start with very first module. Look at this image. What is this? This is computer. Everybody know what is computer. It is a combination of hardware and software, but it can't run automatically. If user want to connect the computer, then how we can connect it? We can connect it with different programming languages like C, C++, Java, etc. But this machine can understand only one language, and that is binary language. So these all type of different topics we are going to discuss in our first module, like block diagram of computer, then concept of hardware and software, different types of languages, etc. Switch to the second module, and that is fundamentals of C programming. Our actual C programming will start from the second unit. And who is the founder of C programming? So Dennis Ritchie was the founder of C programming, and C was developed in 1972 at Bell Laboratory of USA. And today I am going to discuss some basic fundamentals in brief with one sample code. So look at this code. Here, void main. Main is a function and it is a mandatory function. We have to write all the statements of our program in compulsory in this function. And what is integer? Integer is a data type. We have many different data types like float, character, etc. And A, B and C are the variables. What is the use of variables? Variables are used to store data in memory. How it will store? Let us see. This is memory. And here, in this code, we have total 3 variables, A, B and C. So A, B and C will be stored in memory. And 10 and 20 are the inputs of A and B. So 10 will be stored in A variable. 20 will be stored in B variable. Now move to the second statement. Second statement is C is equal to A plus B. If you want to do any arithmetic operation in programming, then we have to use different operators. Here plus is a one arithmetic operator. So after executing this statement, 10 plus 20 will occur and final answer 30 will be stored in our variable C. So in this way, all the data will be stored in memory. So in this module, we will see history of C programming, then basic structure, that how we can write our C program, then different data types, C tokens and operators in detail. Our upcoming module, module number 3, is control structure. So let us understand with very easy example. Just see the image. It is a temperature testing machine, and nowadays everywhere temperature testing is compulsory, right? So if your temperature less than 100 degree Fahrenheit, then you are safe. And If your temperature is not less than 100 degree Fahrenheit, then you have a symptom of COVID. So this is a one condition. And if you want to write any type of conditional statement, then we can write it using if statement. Like here you can see the code. In if, we have to write condition, and either condition will be true or false. So here you are saying is a true part, and you have a symptom of COVID is a false part. So in this way, we can write any type of conditional statement. By using this code, we can check the temperature of only one person. But if you want to check the temperature for many more person, like here you can see the 4 person. And if you want to check for 4 person, then we have to use loop. And what is loop? Loop is used for repetition. If you want to do any task in repetition form, then we have to use loop. Here in this code you can see the loop. This is a for loop. In this way we can use it. And in this module we will discuss different decision making statement, looping statement, break, continue and go to statement in detail. Our upcoming module, module number 4, is arrays and string. So just remember the concept of variable. Here you can see integer a is equal to 10, and this variable is contain the value 10. But if you want to store multiple values in the same variable, like here I want to store 4 different values in same variable, then it will possible using array. And array is a fixed size sequence collection of elements of the same data type. And what is string? String is similar to array. It is nothing but it is a character array. If you want to store characters, or you can say your name, then it is possible with string. Here in this example, we can store only single character, like character A is equal to X. But if you want to store your name or any other word, like here you can see the word is book, then it is possible with string. So what is the definition of string? String is a sequence of characters that is treated as a single data item. And in this module, we will learn different string handling functions like strlen, strcpy, and many more functions. And we will see in detail like concept of array, types of array, concept of string, and different inbuilt functions for string. Switch to the 5th module, that is function. Function is mainly categorized into 2 parts. First is a library function, and second is a user defined function. So what is library function? Library function are called as inbuilt function. In previous chapter we have already discussed about the string handling function. So they are predefined function. So it is called as library function. And what is user defined function? We can create our own function that are called as user defined function. And in this module, we are going to discuss about user-defined function. Just see the example of calculator. Here in calculator, plus means addition is a one function. Same way, subtraction is a one function. So these all functions are called as a module. And we can combine these all modules in a one program to solve any complex problem. And the definition of function is like a function is a self-contained block of code that performs a particular task. And the major advantage of function is like we have to create only once, and we can use multiple time in our single program or multiple program. And in this module we will discuss concept of function, then benefits and different categories of function in detail. Our next module, module number 6, is recursion. So what is recursion? A function is calling itself is called as recursion. Means if you are calling yourself is called as recursion. And recursion is the alternative of loop. Loop and recursion both are used for repetition. And the application where we can apply the recursion. So we can apply the recursion in data structure, different sorting algorithm and find all files in a folder and in a subfolder. And we are going to discuss the concept, benefits and applications of recursion in detail. Our next module, module number 7, is a pointer. So what is pointer? Pointer is mainly used to store the address of another variable, and how it will understand, just see the day-to-day life example. This is a bank. The bank with locker system, and here you can see the different lockers. But each locker have a particular unique number, or we can say one unique address. And these all locker numbers are stored in a one register with different owner's names. So this register is called as a pointer. So the same scenario will be happen in our C programming in the concept of pointer. And in this chapter, we will discuss basics of pointer, benefits, applications and many more topics. Now our next module, module number 8, is structure. The definition of structure is like, structure is a group of dissimilar data item together. How? Suppose this is a one box, or we can say one variable. And just recall the concept of array. In array, we can store multiple value together, but of only single data type. But if you want to store multiple values in same variable of different data types, then we can use the concept of structure. Here in this variable, we can store multiple values of different data types, like one is an integer, one is a float, one is a character. Just to see the different example of student information. If you want to store in a single variable like student name, student roll number and student marks, all we can store using structure. So it is very important topic. It is not possible in array, but it is possible in structure. And in this module, we will see concept, benefits, nested structure and many more topics in detail. Move to the next module, second last module, that is dynamic memory allocation. So first of all, let us understand what is memory allocation and how we can allocate the memory. So memory will be allocated in two ways. First is a static memory allocation. Now what is static memory allocation? Let us understand with one example. If you want to go for a movie with your friends, suppose you have booked 7 tickets in advance, but at the movie time only 5 friends are available, and due to some emergency 2 person would not able to come, then what happen? Your remaining tickets will be waste. So the same thing happen in static memory allocation. We have to allocate the memory in advance, so there will be a chances that at run time memory will be waste. But for overcome from this problem, we can use dynamic memory allocation. And in dynamic memory allocation, memory allocate at runtime, so our memory will not waste. So this is the advantage of DMA over static memory allocation. And in this module, we will discuss concept, benefits and functions, like how we can allocate the memory, how we can deallocate the memory at runtime using dynamic memory allocation. And last but not the least module is file management. What is file? File is used to store data in a computer, and many different types of file are available, like document file, presentation file, text file, etc. And in this module, we are going to discuss different text file and binary files with different modes and different input-output function of a file. Okay, today I explained many topics regarding C programming. So if you are interested, don't stop here. You got a great chance of start the exploring and enjoying the journey of C programming. And we will come very soon with our first module, that is Introduction to Computer and Programming. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.